They get paid to slip and slide on ice. The fans pouring through the turnstiles as Comcast Sportsnet presents the NHL in HD. Tonight, the Blues come bounding into D.C., thirsty for a win against the Caps team that leaves everybody parched at Verizon Center. This is the Grade 8's first career Caps record.
Yeah, you take a look at the guys he moved past, Joe, too. An overtime goal of Bonzai, Miller, Konowalczuk, Pavanka, and Ridley. Nine off the mark, set by NHL record holders, Aljoš Jágr.
Now, Brent Johnson's been brilliant lately, but he's getting the night off. Bruce Boudreau wants to see Semyon Varlamov build off of his Montreal experience.
He was very solid in his first NHL game, 32-33 for Varlamov, Joe. He was controlled, not a lot of extra movement. He was challenging. He played an aggressive style. He stepped out and up to take away the angles of the half shooters. He showed a lot of composure. I thought in a hostile environment, well done for Semyon.
The youngster was plumb tuckered out after he put up these numbers at Bell Center.
Yeah, with his win, Varlamov became the youngest Russian goalie ever to get an NHL win. He stopped 90% of the half shots. Six cap goalie to win in their debut. The first was Bernie Wolf.
That OT game winner for Alex Ovechkin provides win 19 for Washington. Tonight, our game is presented in HD by Comcast. Premier at Verizon Center, where the Washington Capitals have been downright ruthless on their opposition. Tangling tonight with the guys in the white sweaters who hail from St. Louis, Mo. Last home game before the Christmas holiday. And as usual, the stands are packed at Verizon Center for this one. Milan Yurchina sends it on around. Alex Semyon will tap it ahead, playing with a new center iceman tonight. In Michael Nylander, as you look at the line combinations for Bruce Boudreau and defense pairings.
A little shuffling of the top six forwards, you can say. Trying to add a little more secondary scoring, so moves down seven. Gives other guys the opportunity to play with Backstrom and Ovechkin.
Wojtka to start it for St. Louis. Down the alleyway. Alex Steen loads it up and fires, and Varlamov handles that. As he covers up appropriately enough, we share the net-minding matchup.
Brett Lienhart goes for the St. Louis Blues. I'm sorry, Ben Bishop, both the same size, 6'7", 101. Varlamov gets the nod for the Caps. He was super in his debut against the Montreal Canadiens on Saturday.
Locker, 6'7", the tallest goaltender in NHL history.
He goes for the butterfly, and the whole lower part of the net is covered, Joe. You've got to get him to go down and rip him past his two shoulders.
On-ice officials are Mike Lego and Kelly Sutherland. McClement fires, and that's kicked out of there by Varlamov. The linesman tonight, Barton and Dvorsky, wearing the zebra stripes. Alex Ovechkin roaring through center. Throws the head fake on Barrett Jackman, and he wasn't buying any of that. Jackman, a former NHL Rookie of the Year, the elder statesman now on St. Louis's back line.
Well, they're dressing seven defensemen. They're really banged up. The Caps eight guys out. They've got eight guys out. Bad news in St. Louis today. Brewer out for an extended period, Joe, with a herniated disc in his back.
And that's why Jackman is the senior most blue liner with the 11-year pro Brewer on the shelf. We look down on the breakout beginning. Approaching the two-minute mark, scoreless for the NHL on Comcast Sportsnet. Washington and St. Louis this year, one and done. Only meeting between these two interconference rivals. Perron will dump it in. Sean Collins is there first for Washington, ahead for Eric Fair, who's back in the lineup for the Caps. Fair, wearing 16 in the red, serves it for Tom Pody, and all by his lonesome, he'll stride through center. On the lead through David Steckeling down. The touch-up made by Koliakovo, and it's icing against Washington.
It's going to be so important for the Caps again to have a good start for Bruce Boudreau. Knows the other bench boss very well, Andy Murray, who does a heck of a job. They work together in tandem, working in the Los Angeles Kings organization. Murray, the coach in the NHL. Bruce Boudreau, the coach in the American Hockey League with Manchester.
We asked Bruce Boudreau about Andy, and three words came to mind very quickly: organized, thorough, and knowledgeable. Face-off in the offensive zone for Murray's gang. It's won by Washington. Even strength, five-on-five, as they dig for it along the dasher. St. Louis tonight dressing seven defenders. As Fair will loop this one into a corner. The former Flyer, Jeff Boy Witka, bangs it back onto the Washington side. That's where Mike Green will take over. Pressure comes from the veteran Keith Tkachuk. Boyd Gordon will scoop it in. Mike Weaver hustling back to it. Boy Witka channels it up the boards. Brashear on the intercept. Gordon from the angle, wide of Bishop. Alsner keeps it alive in the offensive zone for Washington. Shots on goal favoring the Blues in the early going by two. Alsner sprinkles this one towards the cage and it's knocked away. Boys looking for an alleyway down the wing, cuts to the middle. Backhander stopped in front. Milan Urchina protecting Semyon Varlamov.
He's really found a home in St. Louis. Boys very nifty with the puck, Joe. He has a nose for the net. 16 goals, leads the Blues. Beware of him when he's on the ice. He's stealth-like. He's sneaky with the puck.
Simmons cruising back in with Nylander. Puck checked aside as it was David Backes in good position. Nylander gets it back. Playing catch with seven. The pass for Morrison gets away, and the Capitals will have to rewind. Approaching the four-minute mark of the scoreless first period. Green carving away from Winchester's advance. On for Brooks Light, who had a tally in Washington's OT win on Long Island. Light closing in, fires it off the post. He had Bishop beaten.
You notice Bishop went right to the butterfly, and that's exactly where you have to shoot the biscuit. That rang the pipe. Real nice-looking snapshot by Brooksy.
Barrett Jackman takes the reverse pass from Koliakovo, but does not clear. Alex Semin in the high slot, fires one wide. The ricochet to Nylander sets it for Semin. Back for Nylander again. Puck possession game. Green one-timer. Wide of the goal. Lively boards. It caromed right through the paint. Nylander to Morrison. Wrister on the way. Bishop makes the stop. Follow-up chance. He got that one, too. On Semin. Green uncorks one. Deflected down and off the Blues netminder. Washington with furious pressure here. Semin curls one wide of the goal. And it's golfed back. All the way down the Blues relieve the pressure. Icing washed out as Bishop catches his breath. Green tried to float it on the wing for Backstrom. That's snared. Steen comes hustling down the alleyway. His wrister blocked by Pody. At the doorstep there for a moment. Crombie was dangerous. Blues and Caps scoreless. 5:20 into the opening stanza. Backstrom in ahead of the play. This is offside against Washington. Just a few moments ago, Locker, the Caps got acquainted with Ben Bishop.
And that little change of line, Nylander, Brooks White, and Semin putting on a clinic on the forecheck. There's the one that rings the pipe. Brooksy wide open front of the net. Notice the quick carom. This puck right through the crease, actually off the blocker of the goalie Bishop. Real good pressure early on. Something you want to establish against a hurting team like the Blues playing away from home.
Viktor Kozlov slots one for Backstrom. They work the cycle to Ovechkin. Pounded on the outside by a native of the Czech Republic there, Roman Polak. And the game's first penalty comes here. A hooking call. Between now and then, we share time with Al Kokin.
But Joe, you and Craig were commenting on the line changes, particularly in the top six of the Washington Capitals. Craig makes a good point about trying to get some additional scoring. But I also think Bruce Boudreau is trying to send a message. You did the play-by-play on the Versus the other night, Joe, and I think you were watching that first line. Some nights, some points of the night, they were dazzling, like the behind-the-back pass that Semin threw Ovechkin. Other times, I thought you were calling it Harlem Globetrotter game. They want to get a little less fancy and a little more workmanlike. I think we're seeing that already tonight. Back up to you.
See how the new partnerships come together as you check out the special teams numbers. Blues power play just a shade less than 23%. Berglund, rookie Swede, high score for St. Louis. Straightaway for Allsrister, knocked down by Boyd Gordon, who's right in that shooting channel. This is Berglund, 21 in the white. His pass into that danger zone. Boys, the team-leading nine power play blockers. They set it back. Koliakovo fires. That did not get through traffic. And David Steckel will clear.
And boys, when you look at their power play, that's one thing that has been humming along nicely for Andy Murray. Boys involved in over 50% of the goals this season, scored with the extra man for this St. Louis team.
Loose puck for just a second. Blues able to keep in. Perron doing the honors for Alex Steen. Steen, the former Maple Leaf. Great look inside. Snap wide by Brad Winchester. Quality scoring chance there. Boy, Whitman loads the gun. That's deflected wide by Steen. Backus for Steen below the goal line. On top for Roy Whitka. Steen through the seam. Nice look. Mike Green recovered well on Backus. Power play another 33 seconds. Steen on the outside. They work the overload. Coming back this way. Steen fires. Stopped by Varlamov. Brooks Light without his stick did not throw it clear. Boy Whitka right on through Light. They isolate on him. The point blast coming from Ewan that did not get through traffic, and the Caps penalty killer survive. Steen racing in, fires, and Varlamov confidently on the angle there. Barrett Jackman slows it down in the corner. Spins away from Fleischman. Long wrister with Backus setting the screen. Crombie and Backus work the interchange. PJ Crombie to the front. On guard there was Backstrom as Heino tried to bat it out of the air. Varlamov will cover. Semyon Varlamov's first Verizon Center experience going well. Four straight, six of the last seven as they tangle with the Blues tonight in D.C. Our Toyota Ones to Watch locker room. A pair of former rookies of the year.
Yeah, 3 years apart. Barrett Jackman, the big rig on defense, picked 17th overall. Seventh season with the Blues. Fought through injury problems, but now healthy and a real factor. And for the Caps, Alex Ovechkin, he won the Rookie of the Year award back in 06. Two guys to watch, brought to you by Toyota tonight on CSN.
Barrett Jackman in the injured list, like you were mentioning, the shoulder, the jaw in the pass. Rugged blue liner. St. Louis has the shots on goal advantage, 6-2, thanks in part to their power play, which went awry. Crombie working in with McClement. Varlamov with a routine stop to the corner there. As these two squads are 5-on-5. Jackman for McClement. Hatchets that one wide of the goal. Polak into the corner. And yes, we did check the pronunciation on Roman Polak, and that's what he prefers.
They played hard the other night. This Blues team, the one thing about them, they've got a lot of young blood in their lineup, Joe. They play really hard for Andy Murray, and the game they lost against Calgary was real tough, real physical.
Plenty of fights, right?
Yeah, like five fights in that game.
Tkachuk hiding behind the D. Keith Tkachuk, high-scoring American-born center, slash winger, fumbles, and Ovechkin goes the other way. With Backstrom in his wake, Ovechkin fires wide of vision. Follow-up chance for Backstrom off the outside of the goal. Yurchinin keeping it along the dasher. Ovechkin marked there by Yundling. Jonas Yundling, Tyson Strachan, both making their NHL debuts this evening in Washington, D.C.
Calgary coming off a loss. Caps coming off a win, but not happy with the way they won. They wanted a more spirited effort tonight.
I know for St. Louis, through center with Jan Stastny, the older brother of Colorado star Paul, and another son of former NHL great Peter.
They spent a lot of years with the St. Louis Blues.
Strachan will send it in. Washington will begin its breakout with Mike Green in possession. Green, since coming back off the injured list, getting more and more minutes as he feels more and more comfortable with that ailing shoulder. Bishop slugs it on the wing. Stastny will trickle the center. So I'm assuming the Caps made a phone call to the Providence College Friars captain today for a scouting report on Ben Bishop.
Yeah, I see him quite a bit. I mean, you look at him and his main career, just terrific. During the first part of his 3 years, he was tough to beat. Last year, they finished ninth, did not have a lot of support, and he was a little nicked up.
I don't care what you have to say. I want to hear what Kyle has to say about him. He's the one who scored on him.
Use the rat.
Okay. See how it turns out. Nylander on for seven. Alex Emmons spins, throws it to the high slot. Backus was there looking for the quick counterattack. And Semin cleaned up his mess with Leik on the wall. Roy Whitka keeping an eye on him. Brooks Leik pedals it back for John Collins. Semin waiting behind the goal. Nylander posted up. Points it for Pody. Intentionally shot wide looking for the carom.
They're using that more and more around the NHL, but even the Caps have picked that play up.
Semin spins and fires. He sent it wide. Hody, well up on the play. Tries to go backdoor there for seven, and it was nudged aside by Bishop.
That was a great play by Bishop because that was a layup for the Caps, Alexander Semin. He was so wide open. Poor coverage by the guys in white. Semin was on the doorstep, their goalie to the rescue.
Alex Semin waiting his next turn. Jumps on the bench. McClement with a forecheck on Green. Jostled in from the puck. Steamed point position for Koliakova. Unlin, high slot McClement. And Morrison was in good shape defensively. More than halfway through a scoreless first period with the NHL on Comcast Sportsnet in HD tonight. Joe Beninati, Craig Laughlin, and Al Kopin with you. Visiting St. Louis in town, the Blues with a mark of 12, 15, and 3. McClement holds. No room in front of the goal. David Steckel was right there. One point you were making about the Capitals' most recent win on Long Island. There were times when they were ragged defensively. You figured they would want to be a bit more buttoned up to help Varlamov tonight.
And this is a similar team. You look at the Islanders, you look at the Blues. Similarities abound between those two hockey clubs.
No score in this one. On the other side of our commercial break, Al Kopin will chit-chat with assistant coach Dean Evason.
Got a young goaltender in net tonight. How's he looked to you so far?
I think he's been terrific. And actually, we've got two young goaltenders. They got Ben Bishop down there, and he's playing very well for them, too. So it's a good contest for us.
Do you ask your defenseman to do anything differently with a young goaltender like Varlamov?
No, we have to keep it the center to play. We have to play above the blue lines here and try and force the issue up around the blue line or red line and let him make his stops.
All right, Jay, thank you very much. Gentlemen, back to you.
Guys, we appreciate it. Carl Alsner sends one wide to the 22-year-old in net for St. Louis. Ben Bishop, Semyon Varlamov, just 20 at the opposite end of the arena for Washington. Fellow countryman Alex Ovechkin in there on the forecheck. Kachuk sends it on around. With 7:15 to go in the opening period, still looking for the first red light inside of Verizon Center.
You can tell both the goaltenders are young just by looking at their equipment. Perfectly white mats. No logos, no color schemes. They haven't had time to get set with their masks yet.
Either that or they're saying, hi, we'll work here. You can put your advertising and artwork here if you'd like to keep me in the NHL.
Well, I know Bishop got one in training camp, but it didn't fit right, and it was the wrong style, so they can't send this one in because this is his only mask.
As he covers up, this is his second recall from AHL Peoria. Folks, you can see tonight's game on Channel 1 on demand from Comcast. See this contest and other great Cap specials by pressing your on-demand button, select sports and fitness, and then find Comcast Sportsnet. On a Thursday night in D.C., plenty of fans here in attendance, ready to roar for a Washington team that is 12-1-1 in the nation's capital.
Well, averaging over 17,000 here at Verizon Center, about a 35% increase, Joe, when you look at attendance this season compared to last.
Amazing what winning in a pretty manner will do for you. Blues in town, trying to sully that record a little bit. This is a St. Louis team that has had tremendous success over the last decade, you could say, against Washington, albeit in limited installments.
Probably a lot of fans here tonight also, because a lot of the fans haven't seen these guys in about 3 years here in Washington.
Been quite a while, and with that in mind, Locker, tell us three things we should know about tonight.
Well, the Caps have won 4 in a row, and they've also won 8 of the last 11, Joe. The Caps are 21-1-1 in the last 23 that Alex Ovechkin scores a goal, and the Blues got to be better behind their blue line, allowing way too many goals the last 7 losses.
Andy Murray and Ben Bishop will be comforted to know. I'll add another thing you should know. The Caps' last regulation win over the Blues, December of 97. That's right, December of 97. Crombie steers it right to the doorstep, and Varlamov will plant it there. With 6 minutes to go in this opening period, we saw Varlamov in Montreal with a very, very good display of athleticism.
Yeah, and challenging style. Brent Johnson sits this one out. I expect him to start Saturday afternoon against Philadelphia up Highway 95. Joe, already 10 wins for Brent Johnson, the former St. Louis Blue.
Most since he was a Blue in 02-03. Very much looking forward to that Saturday afternoon showdown with the Flyers at Wachovia Center. They've been just great at home lately.
Yeah, they have. The Philadelphia Flyers. I mean, you look at the young stars in the NHL. Last year, maybe the last couple of years, you wouldn't say Carter, you wouldn't say Richards. Well, they've come around. They have been terrific for the Flyers. It's going to be a real top litmus test for the Caps come Saturday afternoon.
Offside on the rush. No score in this one. Alex Semin will try to change that on the other side of the break. Craig, the babyface Semyon Varlamov looks just fine.
Yeah, he had the totals for Montreal, and now the totals in his first 39 of 40 shots that he's faced. Varlamov has had the answer. The Blues have really pressured him. Boys and Steen and guys like that can chuck, can score goals. He's had the answer. Varlamov, his first home start, faring very well.
With that win in Montreal, he set himself on top of the heap as far as Russian-born netminders.
Yeah, just about 2 years younger than Happy Boulin to record his first NHL win. Grigalov, Krepelov, and Nabokov all up there below the age of 24 getting their first NHL win.
Well said by you. Semyon Varlamov, just the second cap netminder. You did it beautifully with all those names in succession. Just the second first-round draft pick the Caps have ever used on a goalie. The other one, Olaf Kolzer. John Collins comes ahead for Brooks Light, surrounded there by two Blue Notes. Kronwien winds and fires. Varlamov goes to the splits. Alex Semin loops one out on the wing. Semin with points in four straight since he's returned from the injured list. Washington tonight missing Chris Clark and Sergei Fedorov up front. Motoring back, it's Patrick Berglund. I like what I see from this youngster in St. Louis's lineup. Quick delivery from Boys. Winchester was causing a commotion in front.
A teammate of Nick Backstrom's in the World Juniors for Sweden. I mean, a very skilled big pivot that John Davidson's going to have here in St. Louis for many years to come.
Berglund's got 10 goals already, and that equals the most by an NHL rookie with a flashy Mikhail Grabowski in Toronto. Bishop slugs it on around.
And I look at those numbers, but I also look at the fact that he's a plus 10 on a Blues team that's allowing a ton of goals. That tells you about his play offensively and, more importantly, defensively.
Icing against St. Louis. We hope that you'll be at Verizon Center Friday, December 26th. Caps will be taking on one of the top goal scorers in the league, Thomas Vanek and the Buffalo Sabres. Tickets are limited, folks, so call 202-397-SEAT or log on to WashingtonCaps.com to get yours.
I saw that he was the first NHLer to get 20 goals. I think Vanek has 22 or 23 now, Joe, since Danny Gare for the Buffalo Sabres had 20. You know, at the point Danny was leading the NHL with 20, well, Vanek's been the first since Gare to do that.
Fulfilling and living up to those expectations that have been heaped upon him for quite some time.
You mean money?
That too.
You mean money or expectations?
That too.
They go hand in hand, right?
Victor Kozlov. Richards goal! Capitals take the lead.
Bishop went down a fraction too early, and that one sizzled. It looked like through the body, maybe a seven-hole goal. Sharp angle, there he goes down, and there's that shot, and it beats him short side. One more look, Victor Kozlov waits, then takes it to the net, one little deke, and there it is, past the surprise Bishop, their goaltender here tonight. The Caps score first, a trend we want to follow in tonight's hockey game, Joe.
It has to be so difficult for netminders to look through defenders. Victor Kozlov using Roman Polak as a screen there, and it stunned Bishop. David Steckel, south of the goal line, centering for Fleischman. Blocked away, Fair's next chance. No worries for Bishop between the posts for St. Louis. 3 minutes and 20 seconds away from Pulte Holmes intermission live. Are we on Comcast Sportsnet? Hody keeps it to the outside for Steckel. The puck possession game starting to tilt in Washington's favor as Bishop covers up.
And so important to score first in the NHL, and the Capitals win most often when they do. For Victor Kozlov, with the Capitals after the first period, when they've led nine games at home, they're 8-1-0 in the last nine games. So that's a good number right there for Victor Kozlov and the Caps.
Just the second time Victor has scored against the Blues in 21 career games. Sounds good on the Washington score sheet. A 1-0 advantage with the shots on goal level at 8. St. Louis has had the upper hand in terms of winning faceoffs in this first period, and they'll have another chance to win one for Andy Murray after the icing call.
Ninth season as an NHL head coach. You see his numbers as a Blue. With the Blues, 72, 69, and 25. He's a tough guy. He's a taskmaster, you'd have to say. Very well prepared at everything the Blues do. I mean, from the morning skate on and on and on. Preparation is one of his big-time strengths.
Attention to detail. Capitals won that last faceoff. Just 4 of 15 have gone their way in this opening stanza. Yet Kozlov from back from at 16-14 gives them the lead where it's most important. Lloyd Gordon without his lid working in the corner. Gordon steps to ref there, and Bishop got to the post in time.
Good work by Boyd Gordon, taking a heavy hit in the corner, and that's what knocked his lid off. Heavy hitting down in the trenches against Boudreaux's boys, but a good start here in this first period. This St. Louis Blues team is not going to lay over for any team. Boyd Gordon, a good opportunity as he heads back to the bench for a breather.
Eight other games going on this Thursday night around the NHL. Philadelphia and Montreal colliding, two of the top teams in the Eastern Conference, and the Habs are off to a good start. Beckett on the wrister, spoiled there by Urchina, and high into the end zone seats. The Capitals are matching up with a St. Louis team, Craig, that is missing a lot of important pieces.
Well, starting with Andy Murray's number one goalie, Manny Lagesse, an all-star last year, out with a concussion. He's available to come back Saturday, Joe, but has to pass some of the tests for concussions to return. Brewer Johnson, who hurt his knee in the preseason, Joe. McKee, McDonald, Oshie, Kariya, DJ King, a tough guy, three of the top forwards, three of the top D, and their number one goalie, and that's why the numbers look like they do for the St. Louis Blues.
What, that's all?
That's it.
That's an awful lot, and the Caps can share in that. At one point in time, when you include Brian Hockier in the mix, Washington had 10 guys out. And some marquee players among them. We drift below 2 minutes to go in this first period. 1-0 for Washington, thanks to Victor Kozlov. Brooks Light trying to jump between defenders. Olak deflected it aside. Boys lifting it back to center, out of the reach of back. Alder and Urchina have settled in as a nice duo for Washington. Light hesitates on Roman Polak. He and Tomas Fleischman work out in the offseason in the Czech Republic. 46 in the white. Long drive from Urchina that did not get through. Backstrom for Light. Stopped there by Bishop. And away come the Blue Notes. It's Tkachuk in charge. Keith Tkachuk recently joining the 1,000-point club. Tkachuk swooping to the goal mouth, knocked away by Urchina. Jackman fires, pad save, Varlamov, rebound, he got that one too. Quality scoring chance for the Blues, it's Ovechkin the other way, denied there by Bishop.
Opening up just a little bit now, end-to-end rushing here in this first period. This first period has just flown by, Joe. A lot of tempo to this game between the Caps and the Blues.
Varlamov with a great recovery save on Boys, the top score for St. Louis, keeping it 1-0.
Didn't you tell me last game it's all about athleticism for this young netminder?
Well, the more I see him, the more explosive he gets. And that is truly what the scouting reports were about Varlamov. The athleticism that knocks your eyes out. If you just refine it and polish it over time, he's going to be something special. Ovechkin into the corner with Strachan there. Winchester sends it on around. 7 seconds in the period. Kozlov to the front. Deflection try for Green that just missed. 2 seconds now long. Ovechkin whirls one wide of the goal as the siren sounds. Done with one. Washington in front by one. Thanks to number six from Victor Kozlov. And more tip-top net mining from Semyon Varlamov, who made 11 saves in the opening stanza. Pulte Homes Intermission Live is coming up for you tonight on Comcast Sportsnet as the Capitals entertain the Blues here at Verizon Center. We are done with one. Getting set for a Pulte Homes Intermission Live with a Sports Night update. The Capitals marching onto the rink, looking to take down the St. Louis Blues, leading by one. Back to the studio. Here's David Lee. Start of period number two. Join the rest of a full house here at Verizon Center. NHL action coming to you on Comcast Sportsnet and available in high definition. Joe Beninati, Craig Lachlan, Al Koken with you tonight. As the Capitals match up with the St. Louis Blues, that first period, locker room went by in a blink. It took 32 minutes to play.
Well, not a whole lot of stoppages, not a lot of icings. The team's playing pretty well, wide open a little bit, but very solid between the two blue lines, I thought.
And if you're just jumping back on board with us, it's 1-0 Washington. Victor Kozlov with his sixth of the season. Backus rumbling through center for the Blues, and at the line, whistled down offside on the rush by the linesman Steve Barton, along with Greg Dvorsky.
Well, that was a center drift by Tkachuk, a center line drive, Joe, where he gets to the middle and he tries to hot foot it between the two D. Keith Tkachuk, an impressive career, over 1,000 points in 1,085 games played, one of the top scoring Americans of all time.
512 goals. Crombie looking for steam. The 512 tallies for Tkachuk equal with San Jose's Jeremy Roenick among American-born Yankee Doodle Dandies number one, Mike Modano in Dallas.
Yeah, 27 more than those two, so he's right up there. And he's a guy that can play center, can play the wing. He's unrestricted at the end of this season.
Steen floating in the high slot. Brooks Light was there with him. And back on the Capitals with Mike Green.
Doesn't he seem at the end of every season to be unrestricted? Keep the track.
Yeah.
Lately, he's been a rental guy. And at 60-40, I would think that he'd be here or he'd be dealt at the end of the season. I think he's going to be dealt a contender again this season.
Keith Tkachuk, you mentioned NHL point number 1,000. Let's have a peek.
Well, here it is, November 30th, long-range shot. Empty netter, why not? There it is. And Keith Tkachuk mobbed by the fan, by his teammates. And Keith Tkachuk, all-time leaders, players born in the USA. Modano, 539. There's JR, Keith Tkachuk, Mullen, LaFontaine. All guys, by the way. LaFontaine gave him a call right away. He had a lot of different calls by the top scoring Americans when he got 500 and when he got his 1,000 points.
Well, that was a pretty capable list of guys who wore the red, white, and blue. You could win a few games with that five-man unit.
I think if LaFontaine would have been healthy and his career not jeopardized with that concussion and ended up not playing anymore, he probably would have been the all-time leader. I just think he was something special. Modano now has the lead, could end up that way.
All of the pleasures to watch. Tkachuk bombs one right to Varlamov's gut. Semyon Varlamov getting his first start at Verizon Center. Protecting a 1-0 Washington advantage, giving Brent Johnson the night off. Capitals next in action Saturday afternoon at Wachovia Center with high-flying Philly. Brister coming. Varlamov had the answer for that from Backus. Laid to safety by Urchina. Baron Jackman pouncing on it for St. Louis. On the hand-to-hand at the line. High note with Stastny driving towards the cage. Green ushers it ahead for Kozlov. No running room afforded him. Stastny will fling it back behind Varlamov's crease. The hitting starting to intensify. Fleischman, full blast. Fleischman on the hesitation. Beautiful moves. Denied there by Bishop. Fleischman with a fancy stroll. Steckel fires. That's knocked down. Fleischman pouncing on a rebound, working with Fair and Steckel this trip for Bruce Boudreau. 1-0 Washington has the advantage as the Blues counterpunch. Patrick Berglund will dump it on the round. Stastny is there first. St. Louis on the road in the white sweaters. Tkachuk protecting it well along the boards. Wojtka keeps it deep for Berglund. wrapped up there by Morrison. Patrick Berglund's wrister trickles wide off of a deflection in front. Even strength, 5-on-5. Kachuk slowly to the front of the goal. No harm there for Mike Green. Perron right there with him. One of the youngest Blues in history, number 57 in white, when he started last year. Just 20 now. Green showing off for the fans. He'll dump it in to get the change.
And that Perron's a fancy banjo. He has games with assists in his last five straight games.
Bradley at the line, locker offside on the rush. Just a few moments ago, it was Fleischman bringing them out of their seats at Verizon.
Yeah, some pretty good dancing at the line, you'd have to say. There's an isolation at Thomas. Up the middle, zips around the D, just onside with Steph. Steph around, Cody up the ball.
And the young defenseman who they got in that deal for Stepniak from Jarno, Flash, showing some speed, especially through the neutral zone. It's so important to generate speed at the right time. Timing is everything. That was perfect timing to turn the Jets on against Oriakovo.
Speaking of time, 4 minutes gone by in the second. Collins for Pody, and right back. Collins bombs away, and Bishop will squeeze with the glove and pad.
Good save, long range. Collins the blast. One thing the Caps defenders are good at is getting the puck through. And Collins, long range, gobbled up by Bishop. You look at his numbers this season in Hershey in the American Hockey League. Not a lot of points out of that type of guy. Collins is a sort of that throwback, a stay-at-home type guy that limits his mistakes.
Getting about 14 and a half minutes a game, Locker, from the coaching staff, as the Capitals are still without Erskine and Sloan and Schultz on the back end.
And Brian Hoffier,
yes,
started skating full equipment.
Great news. Winchester explodes out wide, and then fans on the wrister. Undaunted, he works it from behind the cage with Pody right there in his grill. Backstrom has it for Washington. On for Victor Kozlov. Those two collaborated for the only goal in this game. Working tonight with a great eight. Ovechkin to the front, answered there by Kachuk. Alsner has some time. Ovechkin from the outside, wide of the goal, manned by Ben Bishop tonight for St. Louis. Born in Denver, grew up in St. Louis, and now about to face the Washington power play, it appears. Discussing Washington's injuries on the blue line, and in fact, throughout their entire lineup. Here's the list.
Yeah, here's the injury report. You mentioned quite a few of them. Schultz and Clark, still with that forearm. Fedorov, still that wonky ankle. Theodore has the hip problem. Erskine, close to returning with the concussion issues, has to go through testing to get the okay. Sloan and Pothier still out. Over 150 man games lost. The hook from behind, an easy call. The Caps go to the power play. Not a good hook by Thomas.
Mike Green out there for Washington. Power play for the Capitals, over 23%. Green right there when it comes to power play goals from defenders. 7 of his 8 on the season with the extra man. Ovechkin made one more look for Semin. Alex Semin bumped by Jackman. Green keeps it in. Ovechkin waiting for the play to develop. Green comes straight away. Thought about the slapper. Ovechkin marked on the outside. Green turned away by Steen. Backstrom through the seam, blocked. But Clement gets help from Roman Pollock, and he will get it out for the Blues.
A real bad clear by the Blues just about cost them. This penalty-killing unit, Joe, for the St. Louis Blues have allowed a power play goal in 8 straight games, killing at just over 66%. That's not going to do it for Andy Murray's hockey team.
But when they win hockey games, it's the penalty-killing group that's one of the stalwarts. They kill at 92%. Against Washington, that's going to be tough, though. The Capitals have been humming right along.
He looks pretty intense, doesn't he?
He is. By nature. And especially during the live action. As Weaver will gun this all the way down.
I remember he was a long-distance runner. He used to run a ton. Looks like he still does. Tremendous shape.
Running back through center, Ovechkin with 7 on the duck down. Bishop did not slow it. High note is there, the former Colorado Avalanche. As they work along the wing, and Jan Stastny will fling it back onto the Washington side of the table.
High note, sort of an energy guy, you know, won that cup in Colorado. Unrestricted at the end of the season for John Davidson and the Blues.
Nylander marching in. hits the brakes, forced back by Jay McClement, the 25-year-old Ontario native, doing the job defensively. And to this point, the Caps' power play has stalled. Brooks Light, finished off by Pollock. Jackman comes to support, McClement too, and St. Louis will clear.
No shot for the Caps' power play, and that's a good stymie by the St. Louis Blues penalty killers. They've been aggressive, they've kept everything to the outside, which are all good signs if you're a Blues fan.
Fleischman zipping in, and at the line we get a whistle here.
That's going to be interference against Eric Fair. The old cutter cross, and the Blues will go to a power play in 2 seconds.
Folks, here's a reminder on Esterman Estate Jewelers. They're located in White Flint Mall. They've been servicing customers with competitive pricing for buying, selling, and trading gold and jewelry at fair market value for over 29 years. Try Esterman Estate Jewelers.
One of the toughest things in hockey is coming up ice in full flight and trying to straddle the blue line. And that's what Fair did. It's incidental contact at the blue line, but he knocks down a Blues player who's trying to stand up, and it's a penalty. It's an easy call. You try to enter under control. You try to crisscross, Joe. I've had a couple of those in my career where I actually ran into Alan Hallworth or Greg Adams at full speed in the center of the blue line. It's tough to straddle and keep onside.
Blues power play stats packaged by the UPS store. Keith Tkachuk and friends getting there. Opportunity now to skate 5-on-4 with Eric Fair boxed in.
Walt looks energized this season, Keith Tkachuk. Looks energized.
I'd rather you call him Walt than some of his other nicknames.
I'll hold it with Walt today.
That's just fine. Perron and Koliakovo working in back. Berglund with Tkachuk. And boys across the top. Cody is there. Measured along the boards by boys. His centering pass was deflected away. Good work by Boyd Gordon, and he'll get it on down. The towering Ben Bishop will set it up for the youngster Perron to scamper through center. This is one behind Semyon Varlamov with 12:20 to go in the second period. They shift gears, come this way for Perron. Keeps it along the boards. Boys, a little bump set action coming from Koliakovo. Winds and fires wide of Varlamov.
And this is the type of game that you miss a guy like Johnson, who's out for the season in St. Louis, in a golf cart accident, Jeff.
Yes, it was. And when I read the clipping of that a long, long time ago, I'm like, no, that can't be the way it happened. But it did.
His foot got caught between the gas pedal and the brake.
Good boy.
And he's out for the season. Total reconstruct of his knee.
Former number one overall pick. Great Minnesota Golden Gopher, if I'm not mistaken. Wojtka with a slapper that Steen was hoping to deflect. Steen, back for Wojtka. Fires. Knocked down in front. Backhander chance. Ooh, Backus had Varlamov reeling in the crease. 8 seconds of the power play. Wojtka cruising in from his point position to bounce by him. Capitals make a break for it. Steckel sending in Bradley. Backhander denied there by Bishop.
It was a great play all around. It looked like Steck just had enough to saucer a backhand. And then Bradley got a backhand away, but just about got past Bishop.
Backus fires one wide. Back to even in full strength. Crombean skipping below the goal line. Away from Alsner with a centering pass, and Varlamov had the goalie stick ready. McClement deflected down. They score! A tough bounce right between the wickets of Varlamov, and the Blues are level.
From up here, it looked like Backus got the first touch, and we're going to see who they'll give credit to. But Backus, the big guy, number 42, was right in front of the net, and that puck bounced down. It went from high to low and through the wickets of the netminder, Joe. Here's the look across. Watch it come from the point. Watch Backus in front of the net. Just a little rotation, and to me, he gets a chunk of that, and he'll get credit with the goal. The Blues have tied it up here on Comcast Sportsnet. Great view right there. Backus tucks one home on a deflection. The Blues and Caps knotted at one.
Coming into tonight's action, Backus was the fourth leading goal scorer on this team. He's been averaging a point per game over the last 8 outings. And St. Louis is locked in a 1-1 draw in D.C. Ovechkin jumping to the inside. He got taken down. Power play time coming for the Caps. Big blast from the outside from Morrison. Clips off the ring.
Comcast Sportsnet, and it's a rotation of the puck coming around the wall. And watch when it gets to the D here. We're going to highlight something. When the puck comes to the half wall, hold it right here. Watch this guy in front. That's Backes. Watch the good stick as the puck comes on the shot, and there's the deflection. No chance for the goalie, Varlamov, to stop that, Joe. Just a change of direction. He was standing upright, and there the puck goes between the pads.
Kozlov has the one for Washington. Backes the one for St. Louis. In this interconference matchup, only meeting of the regular season between these two. Washington goes to a manpower advantage. These power play stats packaged by the UPS store. Alexander Ovechkin finding Mike Green. Semin relays for Ovechkin. He gets the line. Backstrom's feed was blocked away.
I remember their last power play, no shots on net. They've got to figure out this penalty killing to get some shots and rebounds against Bishop. They have not tested him enough in this hockey game.
Strachan with a quick reverse there. And then it's dumped all the way by Jackman. As Green will turn for Washington. Just over a minute to go in this power play. Stastny hunting him down along with Weaver. And the Bluebirds are out in D.C. None too pleased with Washington's power play productivity so far. Bodie lobs it into the corner. Fleischman there arm-in-arm with Jackman. Nylander is next. Bodie on the outside. Nylander still on the perimeter. Goal line pass. Fleischman spins from Jackman. Gives it to Nylander. Cody with a screen developing, fires, it's knocked down in front, and Hino will swat it to safety.
And notice there, Joe, it's one and done, and the Blues doing a good job, number one collapsing, and number two hunting down pucks. So important for a good penalty killing.
Cody has some room to operate with Fleischman. They switch it back up for Ovechkin. It went off of his toe. Strachan will deal it ahead, and this is a two on two. Crombie fires, no worries there for Varlamov as he makes save number 16. Like channeling down the wing, Cap just gets one shot during that manpower advantage. As the Blues are back to a level playing field, 5-on-5. Ben Bishop, their rookie netminder, sends it out smartly for Jay McClemmons.
And for a big goaltender, he's got a pretty good stick, Joe. He works it well. He's been a guy that always likes handling the puck, and he's done it tonight against the Cavs.
Pretty obvious with that outlet pass just a few moments ago. Brashear tumbles it in. Pretty obvious again as Bishop got to the corner. Had to scurry back into the crease as Yurchina was trying to catch him. Jonas Junlin. Young Swede Junlin sets it up and then waits for the breakout to begin. 53 in the white here is making his NHL debut along with Tyson Strachan. This is offside against Washington. As we step away from Verizon Center, we'll hustle you back for more NHL activity in a moment from D.C.
Play's been going on at a pretty good clip. What isn't working tonight?
Well, it's like our whole game right now. We're a little stale. We don't have a whole lot of jump, but we have to find something to energize not only a power play, but our 5-on-5 as well.
All right, do you try and change things up at 5-on-5?
Well, we just want to get some energy. We just want something to happen here and someone to step up and give us a lot of energy, and we can get going from there.
All right, D, thanks.
And guys, that's more than likely why Brashear, Gordon, and Bradley are out there right now. A line that does have a tendency to stir things up. Brad Winchester on the move for St. Louis in the visiting white. Blues fifth in the Central. Washington on top of the Southeast, and the entire Southeast Division is in action tonight.
Man, the Caps come into this game 8 points up on Carolina. They'd like to make it 10 with a Carolina loss.
We're on, fighting for it. Right on top of the crease there, and Varlamov beat him with a pad save, and he got the rebound as well. Oliakovo, the former Maple Leaf wrister, went well wide. Berglund from the sharp angle, that caromed off a defender. Oliakovo with a keep in. Cracking with a long wrister right to the red basket of Boyd Gordon. There's some interference going on at center. Donald Brashear was tied up with a blue, and the interference call is made.
Well, that's important. That the indirect pass off the boards or up the wall, and very tough for defensemen to recover. There you see 62. Strachan heading to the box. There's the indirect. There's Strachan trying to step up on Donald Brashear. So another power play for the Caps to try to get their one-goal lead back.
Tyson Strachan, originally a Carolina Hurricane draft pick,
Yeah, sort of polar opposites last year for Tyson, Peoria and Las Vegas.
American League and ECHS.
Completely different, not only leagues and cities.
I get your drift. Long wrister right to the glove of Bishop. Ovechkin testing the youngster between the pipes for St. Louis.
Yeah, long range shot for OV, but getting shots through is so important to establish your power play. You look at his numbers through 30 games, 42 points, right up there among the league leaders.
Fires again, Bishop the stop. Big rebound, and McClement will haul it ahead. Two on two, racing with Alex Steen. And the pass just a bit strong for him. Steen got knocked down, was looking for a call. None from the referees tonight, Mike Lego and Kelly Sutherland. Seventh. Working from board to board for Ovechkin. 80 seconds on the power play for Washington. Trying to get the lead back against the visiting Blues. Seven. For Victor Kozlov working the goal line. Polak waving that stick in the passing lane. Ovechkin soccer style to Cody. Kept to the outside by Barrett Jackman. And again, Washington will have to chase. 5.5 left to go in this middle stanza. Ooh, Ovechkin. Got a little careless there with Jan Stastny, no harm done. Seven, trying to get fancy, and Stastny says go away.
Notice when you get frustrated, you try to then do things more by yourself rather than as a team. You try to play individualistic, and that's sort of what's happening now on their power play.
Nylander forced that one, and Jan Stastny will shovel it all the way back. We are 1-1 with the NHL on Comcast Sportsnet. Joe Beninati, Craig Lachlan, Al Kopkin with you tonight, surrounded by so many talented men and women in our crew. We're missing one of them, cameraman Terry Wallace. Hope you're feeling much better today. As the Blues are able to clear this one all the way down, Strachan will be set free from the box in 10 ticks. Nylander, hopping back through center. Working around a little screen, set for him at the blue line. Backus took him to the boards. Polak angled spare to the dasher just the same. And St. Louis's penalty killing continues to be stout. Strachan serves it along. Crombie will dump it in, and Andy Murray will get the change he wants. Mike Green with his head up looking to create along with the youngster Alsner. Only Drew Doughty in L.A. and Luke Shen in Toronto play more minutes than this Capital rookie blue liner.
Yeah, it's amazing. You know, in the past, we've never had 20-year-olds having an impact for that matter in the NHL, especially blue liners. A lot easier for forwards of a young age, Joe, to have impacts among teams. It's been a real good year in the NHL for young defensemen making their mark.
We'll see another teenager on Saturday in the lineup of Philadelphia. Luca Spezza, Italian-born defender for the Flyers. Boys has possession for St. Louis. Ahead to Berglund. Patrick Berglund. A fancy Dan on the outside. Smothered there by Yurchina.
That's Yurchina's second or third big hit of this game, Joe. And they want that from Yurchina. They love the way he's playing right now. And you look at him and Alsner working together, plus 14, I think, combined the last six or seven games. They want that physical side, and he's brought it here tonight against the Blues.
Shots on goal, level at 19. Scoreboard even at 1. Collins with a long wrister that's deflected down and wide. Just over 3 minutes separating us from a Pulte Holmes intermission line on Comcast Sportsnet. Again, it's just flying by between the Caps and Blues. Gordon making a beeline for the net. Stopped by Bishop. Rebound score! Victor Kozlov has his second.
Say just moments ago to Al Kopkin, we need someone to energize the team. Well, this is the type of play that does it. I'm not saying it's Victor Kozlov. It's more so Corey Gordon doing the little things, going to the net with a purpose and aggressively. The goalies in the NHL are responsible for the initial shot. The second shot has to have better defensive coverage. Late arriving there for the St. Louis Blues. And the chip shot backhander by Kozzy gives the Caps a lead.
His first multiple goal game of the season. In fact, Ovechkin and Seven usually hog those headlines.
So you think he's happy to be back with that twosome?
working well. Brashear with a backhander. Bishop will glove that and then melt it to the ice. 2:25 to go in the second period. Washington regains the lead, and they congratulate Victor Kozlov all the way down the line.
To go. Real good play here. Watch the pass, number one wide. And when we hold it here, just hold it right here, watch what happens. The importance of driving the center lane by Boyd Gordon. Then the guy that gets the puck has to be boxed out. Hold it here. You must box out in front of the net. They don't box out. Out of the initial drive to the net, Joe, and that allows Kozlov to come in. The young defenseman Strachan caught on the wrong side.
Inside score! Fleischman banked it in off of two posts for a two-goal lead.
Well, they wanted energy, and they just got it. And back-to-back bang-bang goal off the faceoff. Here they are working it. They win the draw. Look at the hustle by Steckel. Steckel has good puck possession. He's fencing off the forward and the defense. And there's bad coverage. Pollock, along with Barrett Jackman, get confused. And there's the double pipe bringer, as my partner just mentioned. Post to post and in. A fine shot that's going to beat most goalies in the NHL.
Locker two tallies, 40 seconds apart. Bear with an excellent feed there to set up Fleischman for his 11th. And the Caps are two better now than visiting St. Louis, nearing the tail end of period number two.
I see Bear back in the lineup tonight. You know, remember, he missed 5 games with that shoulder issue when he hit the glass in Toronto.
John Morrison in a duel with his opposite number 26, B.J. Crombie, the former Dallas Star, who's come to life in a goal-scoring fashion of late for Andy Murray. Ovechkin wrister off the glove of Bishop. We talked with Bruce Boudreau earlier tonight about the two young netminders, each team not having much of a book on the other. He said, advantage Ovechkin because Bishop has no idea how quickly that shot's actually going to come. As he makes a kick-out save there, Semin has this one blocked by Pollock as the Capitals are swarming now.
A couple of bad plays by St. Louis, and all of a sudden the momentum shifts. You make mistakes against good teams like the Caps, and you're going to pay for it.
Jackman steers it on for Alex Steen, and he'll play it on out. Steen brought to St. Louis in that deal that was involving Lee Stepniak heading north of the border.
Yeah, Steen and Poliakovo both came from Toronto. Both first-round picks that didn't develop as quickly as the Toronto Maple Leaf brass wanted them to.
Under a minute to go in the second. This is Tkachuk one-on-one against Yurchina. Hops to the inside, fires, and Varlamov makes a flashy glove save.
That's a fantastic stop. The best save of this game for Varlamov, Joey. Had to stay with Tkachuk, even with pressure going to the net. We saw Boyd Gordon jump into the hole and drive the net. Watch this play. Notice how the player pushes back the D. Real nice play by Perron, the youngster, going to the net. That opens up the lane. Great gobble up by Varlamov, stopping that puck with bad play.
The youngster has a knack for making glove saves in traffic with people practically in his lap. He's protecting a two-goal advantage now as you watch Yurchina reverse this puck to Carl Alsner. Further still for Victor Kozlov, one of the scoring heroes tonight. He's got a pair. His third multiple goal game is a Cap. On top for Alsner, rink wide Yurchina. Didn't shoot it. Kozlov with 15 seconds to operate. Victor Kozlov fires. It's knocked down. Bishop got the glove up in time. Nylander. Hawk tied there by Perron on the outside. 4 seconds. There's a penalty call coming. Nylander being encouraged to shoot it. Running out of time. That will do it for period two. 40 minutes in the books. The hooking call will give the Caps the power play advantage to start the third. In the meantime, Fleischman's 11th, back-to-back with Kozlov's 7th, just 40 seconds apart, and the Caps have the advantage by a deuce.
Home again finishes up against the Buffalo Sabres.
Ovechkin getting set for the start of the third period. We have this NetStar One trivia question for you. We want you to name a netminder for the Blues. NetStar 1 trivia. Who is in net for St. Louis the last time the Caps beat the Blues in regulation? The last time the Caps beat the Blues in regulation, you've got to go back to December of 97.
My memory goes back to the start of the week.
You're the memory man.
You have a good memory.
Washington begins this the third period on the power play. Ovechkin fires and scores! A lightning bolt, 13 seconds into the third.
And that lightning bolt could be lights out now for the St. Louis Blues. The Caps up 4-1 on their home ice, 13 seconds. And that's all it took. The Blues called late in that first, second period. And there comes the old-fashioned wrist shot slash snapshot. The one-foot takeoff, and there it is, past the screaming defenseman Pollock. And right into the top corner. Here's what Bishop's looking at. And Bishop doesn't pick it up in time over the catching glove. The Caps up by a three spot.
And that three spot coming in the last 3 minutes and change of regulation time.
So much for the poor showing of their power play. Now they've got one. Now they're fine again.
Washington's power play has been downright just the best in the month of December around the NHL as Boyes meanders through center. Tried to play the wing there for Backes. That was blocked. St. Louis now has allowed three or more goals in nine straight games. The Capitals have four on the board. Winding up with a blast there. Bishop makes the save on Steckel, and there's no rebound.
And Steckel got every piece of that slap shot, so much so he just about lost the handle with his top hand. Alex Ovechkin didn't lose the handle. Just a wicked shot. That's a bread and butter for a right shot. You love going over top of the catching glove. Past the left shoulder and in. He utilized the defenseman as a screen perfectly. No chance for their big netminder.
Hits the 20-goal plateau in the process. The Capitals have been oh so good when he gets on the board. In the last two dozen games, the last two dozen instances in which he scores, 21-1-1. Nylander from skate to stick. Intercepting in front and playing clear in one move. Jay McClellan has been in good defensive position throughout the night. Washington out shooting St. Louis by five. Make it six as Bishop reaches high to knock one away from Brooks Light. Winding it back up for St. Louis in white. Koliakovo for Perrin. Koliakovo! Glove saved there by Varlamov, who flashed out the pad and glove in concert. As we move towards the 2 minute mark of period three. The young gun Perron playing it on the wing. Berglund with a wrister from Boyes right into the gut of Varlamov.
A simple save for Varlamov. And Varlamov getting some great run support here by the Washington Capitals. They've now got 72 even strength goals. They've tacked on a power play marker. And Varlamov looks very solid once again, Joe. Just very technically sound. He doesn't over move. Everything that hits him, it seems like just a cushion to his body.
You just saw on the bench there, plenty of conversations going on amongst the Capitals. There's got to be a lot of on-ice communication, too, between the forwards and the blue liners, between the goalies and the D. Varlamov does not speak English very much at all. He's getting more and more acclimated to life in the NHL after a sharp start to his North American pro career in the American Hockey League. When Witka bangs it back to center, the Capitals will rewind. Weaver hustling up to force Brashear away. Boyes didn't get that one through. Cody pounces on it for the Capitals. On the lead there for Backstrom. Looked down by Koliakovo. Strachan will swing it. As the Capitals will change up on the go. And Ovechkin just hammers in to Koliakovo. Tkachuk at the line. And this is offside. For more on those conversations, here's Al Kokin.
Well, conversation, I think, would be stretching it, Joe, when it comes to the communication that Semyon Varlamov, to my left, has with his defenseman. They told Dave Pryor, tell him two things. Play it or leave it. That's what Mike Green told me before the game. They said that's really the only communication we have with him. Yeah, I think that for the first time almost all night, we saw him come out of his crease and play the puck behind the net. But so far, it's worked. There doesn't seem to be much confusion. And when he makes saves like that, there is no confusion.
Well, the most important thing, Al, is stop it. I don't care about play it or leave it. Just stop it. Keep on stopping. Tkachuk goes to the wing for Backes. Backes gliding wide. Varlamov shrugs his shoulder there, and then he pounces quickly on the rebound with McClement hovering nearby. The referees give him a break and blow the whistle.
Well, I think he's passed the test. You know, earlier yesterday or today, Joe Varlamov said to some of the press, he played, Boudreau had this to say about him. He played very well in Montreal, and we want to see if it was a fluke. Well, I don't think it's a fluke. This kid's for real. Solid between the pipes again tonight.
And I think it was a good move by the coaching staff to keep him out of the game on Long Island a couple nights ago. Just to get him to settle down after all the emotions of his first NHL win. And he's been steady as she goes tonight. As Pody ambles back to make the touch-up here, it's an icing call against the Blues. St. Louis, they'll head home. They'll tangle with Minnesota and Boston Saturday and Sunday at Scott Trade Center, while the Caps will make their way up I-95 to see the boys from Philly.
Well, Andy Murray's team, Joe, it's not an easy road for him. You mentioned those two games. Then they have Detroit after Christmas. Their next seven games are against teams that are just about six of the seven are in playoff position, and all of them have plus 500 records. It's going to be tough with such a depleted lineup for this St. Louis Blues team.
They're hoping to get some of their key ingredients back. Steckel hits the seam. Steckel with a deke. He was being badgered all the way to the crease. Fleischman has it for Washington. Another nice move, but a backhander that was swallowed up. In good shape defensively there. Fleischman funnels for Fair. He gave it up from me. And now Poliakovo sends it for Strachan, and out come the St. Louis Blues, even strength, 5-on-5. Steam, shrugged to the boards by Morrison. Mike Green is there. Wojtka came in for point position. Perron keeps it alive in the offensive zone for the Blues. Green staples him to the boards, and back come the Capitals. Brooks Like with Nylander, 2-on-2. Joining the rush there, Victor Kozlov, who's got a three-point night working. And a couple of goals and an assist. Turnover. Kozlov fans. Nylander, lift check supplied by Tkachuk. Perron and Tkachuk 2-on-2 on the overlap. Keith Tkachuk did not deliver it. And the penalty call is coming here against Washington.
I think it's going to be a holding call from behind here as the referee makes the call, Joe. And it's the holding, so St. Louis will go to the power play.
We'll see if Carl Alsner gets some penalty killing time on the Toyota League leaderboard among rookie defenders. He's way up there.
Doughty, Shen, Alsner, Goligoski in Pittsburgh. What is it, Spezza?
Luca Spezza.
He's a youngster for the Philadelphia Flyers. I'll have a look at him. All guys getting big minutes on our Toyota League leaderboard.
Now that Bogosian is out of the lineup in Atlanta with that injury, Spezza's the youngest defenseman in all the NHL.
And I think that at the time of Bogosian breaking his leg, Joe, he was upwards of 25 minutes a game for Atlanta.
Atlanta in action tonight, having difficulties getting a handle on Evgeny Malkin, who's got a couple of goals. These power play stats packaged by the UPS store for the Blues. Junelin making his NHL debut, broke his stick there on the slapper. Swedish-born defender, and Carl Alsner will roll it all the way down. Ben Bishop will settle it. Wojtka on the wing. Berglund will send it in. St. Louis has the highest scoring rookie class in the NHL. Berglund, one of the primary reasons why, with double figures already. Perron, slapper on the way, deflected, and Varlamov got a chunk of that.
So you always look at the future being bright. You know, he's the glass half empty or half full for Davidson. getting a lot of young guys playing and a lot of guys contributing, so the future looks bright for the Blues.
Oh, they're missing some terrific playmakers in McDonald and Correa. They're missing three of their top six guys on the back end. They're starting goalie, on and on. Fans here upset with the lack of a call. Oliakovo trudging along with Berglund, 7 minutes deep in this third period. Kachuk playing hide-and-seek below the goal line. Settles it for Berglund. That was rejected. Allsner didn't get it out. He was scolding himself for doing so. He threw it right to the defender, Kolyakova. No harm done. David Steckel cleans it up.
Well, the power play for the Blues was a concern last year. You remember the numbers they had, just 42 power play goals, the fewest in the league. They were hoping guys like Jack Johnson, a healthy Correa.
Eric Johnson.
A healthy Correa, a healthy TJ Oshie would help their power play. But now they're out. They have to rely on some young guys and some guys actually probably playing out of position.
Boy, Gordon drops it for Nylander to fire, and that hit traffic as Gordon and Pollock are side-by-side, screening Ben Bishop. The Capitals with three unanswered and a 4-1 lead with the NHL on Comcast Sports. Whoa, Jackman right in there, and Varlamov makes the save. On the regroup, Barrett Jackman will deal it ahead. Crombie slugs it through the goal mouth. Jackman kept it alive for Hino. Now on the handle for Washington. Nicholas Backstrom saucers it along for Semin. Alex Semin looking for open space. Gave it back to Ovechkin. That jammed it. Ovechkin with an early third period power play goal, lengthening the lead for Washington. Crombie crisscrossing with Hino. Now the drop for Stastny, shrugged away by Varlamov. And he covers the rebound. Long enough for the whistle. And he gets a terrific ovation from the fans at Verizon. Semyon Varlamov introducing him. Just a few moments ago, we asked you, that's our one trivia. Who's in net for the Blues the last time the Caps beat him in regulation? The answer, Locker?
Well, you got it.
Grant Fuel.
Yeah, I thought it was going to be Vincent Riendo.
that's a long time ago. And if you don't believe us, just have a look back.
There's Dale Hunter and the boys. There it is. It's over the top shelf over Fuhr. Brunette on the doorstep where he's made a living in the National Hockey League. And Fuhr was actually given the hook in that hockey game when the Caps beat him. McClellan came in relief for the St. Louis Blues.
Boys posted up against Backstrom. The Capitals make the strip. 11 minutes and change to go. Regulation tie with Washington in front by three. Alex Semin trying to loop that one to himself around Backus and Jackman, and they both keep him away. Ovechkin flying in there, putting some pressure on, and Alex Semin stays down in a heap. And Ovechkin comes to defend him.
One thing this team is they're tight. It took a little bit of a response time there, and Jackman trying to get in there. Remember in his earlier days, he was a tough customer and a fighter, and this St. Louis Blues team plays a physical brand of hockey. OV coming to their help and relief of their fallen guy, Alexander Semin, being looked at now by Greg Smith.
You mentioned the Blues. They're top four in the NHL in terms of total fights. Alex Ovechkin is not the guy you want fighting, and nor do you want to see Alex Semin down like that on his stomach.
Well, it was 1-on-4. It was Semin against Backus, Boys, and Barrett Jackman at one point. There's the fall. There's the cross-check that's not called by Backus. And then Alex Ovechkin's going to come in. First the flip, the no-call. Then the cross-check, the no-call. And then OV, like a missile, says, hey, he's staying down. I got to take care of business as one of the leaders on the team. And that's exactly what OV did on that play.
Alexander Semin started this season as the hottest scorer in the NHL in the first month of the campaign. Then was injured. Lost a boatload of time with an upper body injury.
And here's OV coming in at the end of this play. Watch him come in. There he is, right into Backus. And had the original penalties been called, either for the trip, Joe, or for the cross-check, none of this stuff happens. I mean, to me, they're missed calls. You might give them away the trip, but you can't let go the cross-check to the lower back. Semin's still smarting on the bench.
fans now privy to a few replays on the scoreboard here at Verizon Center.
And look who's coming out.
Donald Brashear, the ultimate peacemaker.
One more look at the play. There's the push from behind, and watch his knee and legs trying to get caught up in the ice. Maybe his right knee buckles a little bit there, and then he goes down. But definitely a cross-check there that goes undetected. And now we'll see what's going to go on here. You mentioned majors, 31 fighting majors for the St. Louis Blues, Van and the Ducks. Tied at number one with 37 apiece.
In the last instant that we were sitting on Alex Semin on the bench, we could see him flexing a leg as the officials bear the brunt of this chant inside of Verizon Center. 5-on-5 action continues, 10.5 to go in the third. Capitals with the last three on the board. Compliments of Kozlov, Fleischman, and Ovechkin in a three-goal lead as this is offside against St. Louis. And Alexander Semin makes his wobbly way to the dressing room.
Well, he's had that type of season. It seems he gets hurt, comes back. It's been an up-and-down season. They can't afford to lose one of the top players in the game, and Alexander Semin cross-checked. Looked like his right knee buckles right against the boards.
Koliakovo sizzles this one around the turnstile, the ricochet to the high slot. The Blues have to give chase. Ben Bishop played his college hockey at the University of Maine. He was a Hockey East All-Star. Born in Denver, grew up in St. Louis.
Yeah, his family still has a business there, Joe. His dad runs a business in St. Louis, so they get to see their son and play a lot, obviously. They hope he sticks here, but the number one goaltender, Legacy, is available to return Saturday from a concussion he suffered against Anaheim, but he must still pass the NHL concussion test to be available to come back for Saturday or Sunday.
Blues and Caps changing personnel on the fly here, Locker. As Pody ladles this one in, and now we're getting unsportsmanlike conduct call. As this game is winding a little bit out of control, the referees clamp back onto it. We'll have more in a moment. Craig Victor Kozlov has been shooting straight tonight.
Minor tweaking to the lines, too, is how Victor Kozlov. That's just a nice shot on a sharp angle. On Gordon drive, but then the follow-up. The second and third guys in the wave offensively, so important. Victor was the second guy, and because of that, he has 13 points in his last 12 games. He's been more involved.
Right on the doorstep, Kachuk had a glowing opportunity there. The puck was bouncing and would not cooperate for one of the Blues' top guns. Washington a man short. As Perron wheels back, power play number four for St. Louis.
I thought that might have been a little bit too much chatter from the bench.
Kelly Sutherland and Mike Lego immediately flash those T's for unsportsmanlike conduct. The T sign. Point position. Koliakovo for Berglund. Patrick Berglund drifting below the goal line now. The point position for Koliakovo, and it squirts loose. 8:40 left in this third period. Capitals trying to get to 20 victories before the new year. The last time they did that, Craig, 92-93. Number 20 with it now for the Blues. Steen to the front. It deflects in. Alex Steen centering pass. Karam's home.
I thought that was Alex Steen to Alex Ovechkin. It looked like Ovechkin on the back check had it ricochet off his stick. We're going to have to watch this one more time. But a move by Winchester, a move by Steen. Their line doing some damage, and Andy Murray now excited on the bench. Here comes the play. Watch Ovechkin on a back check against Winchester. Puck comes across, and just as we thought, Joe, that's an Ovechkin goal on the backside, trying to clear it away. Not sure if Winchester touched it before it got to Ovechkin, but Ovechkin taps it, just trying to back check, Joe, just an unlucky break to the Great Eight.
Brad Winchester with a redirect on that centering pass, giving the Blues their second on the night, and then it's offside against St. Louis.
There's a look at Winchester, giving him credit for the goal, driving to the net. Looked like it just went off his shaft, and then Dovi, he gets his third goal of the season. Winchester driving the far post for Andy Murray's Blues.
Former Wisconsin Badger, now working with his third different NHL squad. Edmonton and Dallas preceding time in the Gateway City.
Wasn't he supposed to be a top guy, too? Doesn't he fight a little bit, Winchester?
There's a couple of guys. I think by that name is Rashear. Lowers the boom on Gudlin. And a bloodthirsty
and
crowd at Verizon
Center. Kachuk's going after him. Kachuk went right after him.
And they want to see the gloves come off in the stands. These fans none too pleased with the way Alex Semin was roughed up about 4 minutes ago.
And he tried to nail him again in the neutral zone. The referee coming in lets Brashear away with another hit in the neutral zone, which shouldn't have been a penalty, but the referee made sure he came over and had a little chit-chat. And the Caps trying to take the body now against this St. Louis team.
Craig, it's just a two-goal lead. This is not the time for things to unravel as Backstrom gets floored by Winchester. Down the wing, too strong for Ovechkin. Pollock wins the race, makes the touch-up, and it's icing against the Capitals. 4-2 Washington, and all eyes on Donald Brashear.
Well, they're looking around, and watch this D. Welcome to the National Hockey League, cleaned out by Brashear, and Brashear in the neutral zone. Watch, there's Kachuk coming across, and then Kachuk's going to go right after him. Give him a little cross-check. Say, hey, don't deal us like this. And then down low, the goal scorer, Winchester, next Backstrom. Things heating up here.
Ovechkin on the fly, working down the wing. Ovechkin curling, dragging the inside, lost it on the backhand. Barrett Jackman moving the tempo more to his liking. Through center, it's McClellan. Skids to a stop. Tries to filter this one into the corner for Alex Steen, who set up the last St. Louis goal. Ovechkin makes the rip-off, but not going to work through two defenders. Steen on the hop. Alex Steen working wide. John Collins keeps an eye on him. We have not seen Mike Green very much in this third period, if at all.
Well, we saw him go down the locker room. Wade right into the locker room, maybe for repairs, but he's been in and out, Joe. It seems like he goes to the bench, then he goes to the locker room, then he comes back out. That's been sort of the way he's played out this hockey game.
Less than six to go. Alex Semin has not returned. Blues trailing by a deuce on the road. Backus with a neat move to avoid Morrison, and he sends it. Kachuk. Kachuk fires. Barlam off a huge save there. And hearing it again from the D.C. faithful, the rookie netminder in goal, 20-year-old Russian, with a key stop late regulation.
Yeah, the Caps lucky to have that save, but this period started out well, but then it sort of unraveled. Sort of a carryover from the Islander game, Joe, where it unraveled for the Caps in the third stanza.
They barely had a scoring chance. The Islanders had a dozen or so in the third, rallied to tie and forced the game to extra time. Berglund wheeling away from Alsner. That ricochet winds up on the blade of Tomas Fleischmann. One on three as the Caps are in the midst of a change. I don't like his chances.
Well, sometimes you get so carried away with payback, you forget that the game's still on the line, and you forget about playing a team game. And that's sort of what's happened.
It's not time for roller derby just yet. Yurchina muscles up on Steen. McClement looking for the deflection there over the top. As the Blues are throwing caution to the wind, defenders are pinching way up on every thrust now. 4.5 to go in the third.
And because of that, they've outshot the Caps to this point, 11-3 here in this third period, Joe.
Collins will drift it back behind Ben Bishop. 31-28 now, St. Louis has a shots on goal advantage. The chant is, let's go Caps. A sold-out house on a Thursday. Last home game before the Christmas holiday. Steele and a feed to the front. Bounding away from any pressure. Back come the Blues.
And the last game also before the roster freeze. Players can't be traded by general managers. I think starting tomorrow through the 27th.
Right, you are. St. Louis on the regroup. Sloppy pass in there. Ovechkin fires and a blocker pad save for Bishop. Barrett Jackman looking in his rearview mirror. Turns away from Victor Kozlov. Jackman will bring it ahead.
Jackman's had a good game, Joe. He's had a lot of minutes because of the young D, and Murray keeps playing him a ton.
Offside Blues, who have been dangerous here in the third period, threatening to reel in the Caps. Tkachuk, the latest to make his advance, rejected by Varlamov. Capitals have the advantage by two over the visiting Blues. Plenty of red in the stands at Verizon. And the Washington Capitals know that they can count on their Russian-born players to do their best.
And the Caps back, brought to you by American Service Center. The Caps lineup features five of this season's 27 Russian-born players. No other team has more than two. Semin, Ovechkin, Varlamov, Kozlov, Fedorov, and Brashear.
Nice try.
I thought I'd get one, that one by you. The fans are going crazy here.
Nice try. Penalty call.
They were listening.
Penalty call for tripping coming up. And for once, the fans will give the referees some applause in this third period. They've been on them all frame long.
And there's a breakthrough coming right at you, right up the middle. Eric Fair has had a good return to the lineup. He missed five games, ends up being a couple of weeks doing some extra work. He's had good get up and jump in this hockey game against the Blues tonight.
One more power play goal here would have Caps fans breathing a little easier with 3:15 to go in the third. Enjoying a 4-2 advantage, but the pesky Blues are not going away, and you wouldn't expect them to. A whistle and another call, and I think Semin Varlamov played it outside of the trapezoid. Semin Varlamov handled this
penalty on Washington goaltender. 2 minutes to play to puck in the restricted zone.
Folks, join us at Verizon Center Sunday, December 28th. The Caps battle the Maple Leafs. Mike Gartner's number will be retired in a pregame ceremony. For tickets, call 202-397-SEAT.
And he was in that no-skate zone, Joe, in the Russian Elite League. They don't have that little area. But he got caught playing the puck to the right or the left in the trapezoid, which is not allowed. Now they'll have to have a player serve his penalty. You look down low. It's here, down to the corner. And down to the corner, and then boom, it's back again, and it's right down in that little area that you're not allowed to play the puck. So he gets the minor penalty on his score sheet.
Once he goes below the goal line, you're in trouble. Perron with a blast, it's blocked there by Ovechkin. He thought his hockey stick was broken. As he discards it, the Blues have to rewind at center. This is 4-on-4 for the next 90 seconds, with 2:50 to go in the third. Tkachuk.
And it works as a power play with Bishop out, Joe, so they're going to control it, and the Blues will try to play it like a power play.
Andy Murray lifting his netminder. Berglund rolls one to the front, tries to glove it out of the air. He punched it in with his hand. No goal. No goal for St. Louis.
And the lights go on because the puck did cross the goal line, but Berglund going to the net. You nailed it, Joe. And the referee will go right up to center. No goal. Hand pass. Hand shot. And so they survived there, but Andy Murray's going to call a timeout. There you see the T with 2:31 left. And instead of playing this like a 4-on-4, which is man-on-man, the Caps have to play this like a penalty situation. Watch Berglund come in. There's a left hand playing the puck over the top of the crossbar, too. Doesn't matter, but it's played with a hand, Joe. No goal. Face-off comes outside.
Yeah, that's good in volleyball. It's not good in hockey. You can spike for points in that sport, not here. Andy Murray will decide whether or not he'll keep Ben Bishop on the bench, as the faceoff will at least be in neutral territory just outside the defensive zone for the Caps.
Well, I don't even see Bishop on the ice and ready to go, so I would imagine he just goes with the five guys and hope that they win the faceoff.
San Jose has just been ridiculous at home. The Washington Capitals aren't very far behind them.
Well, San Jose, 944. The Caps just under 90% of the time win percentage at home. Boston, Chicago, and Detroit all have big numbers on home ice. The Caps just one regulation loss.
This one's not in the books yet. A missed draw here. We'll do it again. 2.5 to go in the third. Caps on top by 2. Keith Tkachuk and his gang with a netminder pull. With Miner's penalties being served in both benches, it's a 5-on-4 situation as this will escape the rink.
A good play by Brooksy. The importance of jumping out on Perron and making sure things don't happen. And Joe, some history here on this day back in 1983.
Long time ago.
Again, it talks about the great one. Wayne Gretzky had 4 points to total 100 on the season, the fastest to 100 points. That was just his 34th game.
What took him so long? Morrison on it for Washington. There are so many of those involving Gretzky that you just shake your head at and go, never again.
And notice the Caps playing smart, because even though it's 5-on-4, man advantage, because of the goalie pull, you can't ice the puck yet. So they're making sure with indirect passes, they don't want to have the opportunity to have a puck faced off in their zone.
John Morrison galloping to center towards the open cage and wide. No icing there because he got the center strike. 1:40 left to go, regulation time right now with the Caps in red on top by 2 down the stretch with the NHL on Comcast Sportsnet in HD. Bunted out to the wing. And Brooks Light casually rolls it into the blue zone.
That's just a smart play. I mean, if it's an opportunity and a penalty kill situation, you see guys trying to go for that empty net.
Very quick power play time now for St. Louis. Varlamov will pounce on it. Varlamov's penalty for playing the puck outside of that trapezoid coming into full effect now. You can see tonight's game on Channel 1 On Demand from Comcast. See it and other great cap specials by pressing your on-demand button. Select Sports and Fitness and Comcast Sportsnet.
And the St. Louis Blues getting a ton of shots against the Caps tonight. They've already had 31 against Varlamov, Joe, and they're the fourth fewest. I mean, they don't are the second fewest shot team in the NHL. Only the Thrashers fewer than St. Louis. They're getting their chances against this Caps 20-year-old.
Yep, they're getting an eyeful of him. Or at least he's not Mika Kiprasov, who's beaten him 11 straight times for Calgary. David Steckel fighting for it right off the draw from his knees. Not sliding enough. Into the open goal. Poliakovo got there.
It would be enough if there was somebody curling at that end of the ice. You need the broom out, Joe.
Sweepers.
Yeah.
Eric Fair wins the battle. Eric Fair off the outside of the goal. That would have been a just reward for a very good night for 16 in the red. Fair fires again. That was weakened on the way. Patrick Berglund has it for St. Louis with 45 seconds to play in the third period. Fair pinned in along the boards. Berglund motors ahead. And there's a whistle on the attack. And offside against St. Louis. Our Morgan Franklin pivotal play tonight involving Semyon Varlamov. Ensuring this two-goal lead.
And by the way, against a guy, Keith Tkachuk, when you look back to a couple of years gone by, back to 2001, 8 games, 15 points against the Caps. And Varlamov had the answer, first time he's seeing Keith Tkachuk denied him with that blocker save.
An icing call there with the Capitals back to their full complement on ice. Semyon Varlamov, 33 seconds away from banking a victory for Washington. It would be win number 20 if they hold on. Tkachuk and Backstrom tie each other up on the draw. Backstrom comes away with a biscuit, slides at the center. Alex Ovechkin poaching out there. Goes indirect off the boards. As Victor Kozlov was shooting for the hat trick. 15 seconds now in this third period. One and only meeting between Washington and St. Louis. And the Capitals, who have not beaten the Blues in regulation in many, many moons, are about to change that script. 5 seconds now full. Perron to the front looking for Boyes. Perron gets it back as the thunder sounds. A thunderous ovation congratulating the Caps and Semyon Varlamov on a 4-2 decision in D.C.